Evening, ladies and gents. It's Simon Brown here, not doing this evening's presentation. We leave the FX to Alwyn, who's our FX trader. This evening's presentation by Alwyn Burger from wildtrading.biz. He's talking currency pairs, and what we mean there is dollar versus euro, or euro versus sterling, or perhaps rand versus whatever the case may be. And really, the point being here is which ones. I always typically thought you would be trading, you'd be a cable trader, you know, dollar sterling, or you would be dollar euro. Alwyn says, you've got to find those pairs which are giving you something to trade. As always, we'll take questions at the end of the webinar, either text-based or with a microphone, if you've got a mic attached. With that, I'm going to hand over to Alwyn. As always, this takes a minute. There's a lot of clicking to do.
Okay, what I wanted to talk to you about, I get a lot of queries from people saying, what pairs do I trade? How to find pair to trade? Now, I don't do this necessarily anymore myself, and it really depends on your strategy and it really depends on your focus. For me, I now trade cable, which is pound sterling versus the US dollar, and I trade euro versus USD. And that's the only pairs I look at the moment. I think there's enough trades there to be had, even if it's not lots in a week. But that's how I trade. However, there are a lot of traders who like to choose for the day what pairs are they going to trade. And I've certainly done that in a year or two ago, where I would look at 20 to 30 charts and try and pick out where it is that you're going to trade today. Now, if any of you have had experience with this, it's so often that you will sit and thumbsuck a pair that you're going to trade because you have a bit of an affinity for that pair, and they're absolutely dead. You pick a trade, go short, you go long, and it simply just moves 10, 15, 20 points against you, and it sits there for the day, up, down, in that range. You never get break even, and you don't quite get to your stop loss. And you sit there waiting for this trade to move, and the market across the charts are moving, except the pair or two pairs that you're in. All right? And what I want to talk to you about tonight is, if you're one of those traders who sit and which pairs am I going to trade today? Eeny, meeny, miny, moe. Well, I'm going to give you a little tool and a method, rather than an absolute tool, but a method to apply to work out where you are most likely to find the moves. All right? Now, the theory on this is very simple. Ideally, what you want to do is you want to trade the strongest currency against the weakest. All right? It's no point trading the two strongest currencies in the market against each other, because they're not going to move. You can have a sideways on that day, on that or period or whatever it is. You don't want to trade the two weakest currency pairs or currencies in the market against each other as the pair, because they're also not going to move. And the same applies to any of the middle currency. What you want to do is you want to get the strongest against the weakest. That's where you're likely to get your biggest move. All right, and that's where you want to position yourself in the market. So how do we go about determining the relative strength of the currency pairs? Relative strength analysis. Now, what you want to do, let me move on to the next slide. As soon as I can find it. I hope you guys can see my slide. Can you see that? I'll give it a couple of seconds just to load. Now, this is very simple. And just to tell you, I mean, you could find a lot of information on this on forexfactory.com. I don't know if any of you guys use those forums. Some of the stuff date back from 2002, 2006, there's many ways to skin this cat. You need to find something that works for you. This, for me, is a very simple way that works quite well. All right. I trust that you can all set. simply what I do is I take all the main currency, there's not their crosses, but nothing stops you from putting up your any pairs that you like. You want to trade Czar versus Diner, whatever you can do, you know, whatever it is that you want to determine the strengths and weakness for, you simply put your currency pairs up there. And all I would do is you pick any time that you're going to trade in. So whether you take a 1 minute time frame, 5 minutes, 10 minutes, 1 hour, 4 hour, 8 hour, 24 daily, weekly, whatever time parameters you're going to trade. Right? For this example, I'm going to say M15 or 15 minute chart. It would always be good to take it across two separate charts and a time frame. So for instance, let's say you like to trade 15 minute charts. So that's where your setup and your triggers are. Then I would suggest relative analysis on, say, a 15 minute chart as well as on a 1 hour chart. So you don't want to get small bursts or pop in the market, which will show on the 15 minute, but if you overall for the day, just quiet. Okay. So you would want to see that your analysis corresponds from the 15 minute to the 1 hour. You can see that you are more likely to get the move that you anticipate. All right, what you will do is I would take, for instance, a 15-minute chart, and I'll make a column there, 15-minute. In fact, both columns there should be M15, and I would take my pairs, base currency and your secondary currency. All right, and all you would do on your analysis, where that, for instance, pound USD, whether the chart is going up or whether the chart is going down. Now, there's me. Different preferences by traders. Some would like to look at the nine moving average, and if that's pointing in the upward direction, for them the trend is up. If it's pointing down, the trend is down. Some would like to determine it by whether the market's trading above the 100 moving average, despite any direction that the 100 MA would be pointing in. But if the market's trading above the 100 MA or the 100 MA or the 50 MA, then the market up. This would be according to your technical analysis. It doesn't really matter. As long as you're consistent, you will very quickly see how this works well for you. All right. For myself, I like to determine the 100 moving average. So if the market's trading above the 100 MA, it's positive. All right. However, having said that, I'm not going to say that the pound versus US dollar is bullish when the market's moved up well above the 100 moving average, and it's now I've got 3 or 4 or 5 red candles in a row pulling back to the 100 moving average. That is not bullish, all right? It might be on the longer term, but it's not on that 15-minute chart. Okay, so you do have to use a bit of discretion as to how you apply this, but certainly you'd want to see that your market has shown a trend. All right, on the 15, on the 1 hour, or on the 15 and the 5 minutes, depending on the charts that you're going to use. And the simplest way to score this, if your pound versus US dollar, if your pound is getting stronger against the US dollar, the pound gets a plus sign. It gets a negative. It cannot get to zero. Okay, zeros are for flat markets. So if your market's basically in a consolidation period, moving sideways, they get zeros, but you cannot have a plus and a zero or a minus and a zero, all right? It's a plus and a minus and zero, zero. And simply all you do is you'll pick your 8 or 10 or 12 currency pairs that you are looking at and score them in that manner. So you give them a plus, 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 minus, 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 as they might be. And at the end of the columns, you tally it up. So if pound, for instance, has 4 pluses, and 1 0, then you write there, pound, 4 plus, 4 times plus, and 1 times 0. And you would score each currency pair like that. And that will very quickly give you your strongest and your weakest. So you will, for instance, say, okay, yen has got 3 minuses. Yen is my weakest pair for the day. Pound has got my 2 or 3 pluses. and that's the more pluses than any other currency pairs have. And what you want to do is you want to trade pound versus yen. That's what you want to look at trading then. All right, that's where you're most likely going to get the move that you anticipate. That does not mean you are necessarily going to just take buy the pound and short the yen. You now go back to your technical analysis because you might very well get a strong retracement at that. So if you, whatever, that's a separate issue. But that is the currency piece that you want to trade. That is where the biggest moves have happened. All right? So that makes sense. Guys, this is a very short on that point of view, but I'm quite happy to spend time on questions because if you don't get this right, and this is your style of trading, you're going to be consistently picking the dead pairs for the day. This does take a bit of practice, okay, because you need to get your eye in on this. So please don't just run off with this tomorrow and pick the pair. At least anything that we teach on the webinars, at least just try it on a demo account for a few days. Familiarize yourself with it, fine-tune it, make sure that you are happy with it. Having said that, while you guys are popping up some questions, let me give you another lesson I've learned in the last 2 weeks. I have had the best trade I had this year. Cable, pound sterling versus USD. I picked the bottom within a few pips. I've been long since 53.67. It bottomed out at something like 52.80 or 52.60 or something. So at 53.67, I bought the cable and I'm still long. Okay, I'm 700 pips up, 50 odd percent of my account on one trade. And the lesson is this, not that it was an awesome trade, of course it's an awesome trade, but the lesson is this, I've been so busy getting ready to move house that I've actually not sat in front of the charts all day. I spent half an hour in front of the charts in the morning, quickly look at it at night before I go to sleep. The rest of the time, I've let this thing go. Now, there's many a time I would have, at the front of this chart all day, I would have cut that trade logo. I would have absolutely just cut it because markets are pulling, can you draw the bank a little bit of profits, whatever. Okay, and I would have probably got out of this trade at 78 or 100. But for me, the lesson is sometimes just let the market breathe, okay? And I've always just said, well, what I will do with this, when it starts trading below the 100 moving average, I will get to relook at how I'm going to cut this trade or what I'm going to do with it. And that's been my sort of overview on this trade. I've looked at it on my BlackBerry from time to time. Pepperstone's got software that you can open on BlackBerry. And the once or twice that it got near the 100 moving average, I was too busy doing building renovations to actually see that it was there, and I never hit the panic button. By the time I got back to the computer at night, it was sort of that 100 moving average. That's just a little personal lesson. Okay, let me take some questions.
So, I want to reiterate what Alwyn says. Less is better often. I like that comment. Let the market breathe. Alwyn, two questions in, one from Stuart. He's saying, your plus and minus, say you look at a 15 and a 60-minute, must they both be plus, or can one be plus, one be minus, and that would say that there's enough action happening to do the trade, or to look at the pair?
Okay, sorry, just rephrase it. You are breaking up a bit with it while speaking, Simon.
He's saying, must it be plus and plus for the two time frames, or can it be a plus and a minus in order to trade in that pair?
No, it can be a plus and a minus. However, what would keep me out of that market is if, say, on 1 hour, a cable or pound have got more minuses than pluses. If, for instance, on the 1 hour, I have cable pulling more zeros, which means that that's cheap. It's on a consolidation in the 1 hour, but on the 15 minutes, it's starting to move. All you're doing is you're picking an early turn in the market. You're predicting an earlier move. But I would certainly be very worried if pound, for instance, is negative across the board on the 1 hour, but it's starting to be positive on the 15 minutes, that for me is too, you could just have a small retracement. I wouldn't do that. I'd like to see the pluses, but we're talking hypothetically here because in practice, I have always seen if this market, if you're going to see a market that's tradable, you will see on a slightly longer time frame that those pluses are coming through. You might not have as many. You might find that on pound sterling, you've got one or two pluses, and it might not be the strongest pair in the 1 hour, but it's one of the stronger pairs, whereas on the 15 minutes, it's clearly the strongest. You won't see that it's absolutely flat on the 1 hour if on the 15 minutes it's already starting to move. Does that make sense?
Yeah, that makes perfect sense.
Question?
Is my audio coming through?
In practice, if you sit and watch this, if you watch this on your charts in the days to go and just do this analysis, but do it not, for instance, for the Asia session, do an analysis, then do it for the London session, do another box, and then for the USA session, do another box. And very quickly, over 2 or 3 days, you'll see exactly where you're going to trade for which session and what you expect.
Alwyn, that made perfect sense. And that, as I can see, my audio is coming through. A couple of questions coming through. A number of people asking about the BlackBerry app that you mentioned. What was it?
Okay. I don't want to promote one broker, but it's not a secret that I use Pepperstone. Pepperstone Financial, the Australian brokerage. I'm very, very impressed with them. It's certainly been the nicest trading I have had in years. And they've just brought out this BlackBerry app, so you can actually download Pepperstone's, log into your account at Pepperstone on BlackBerry, and it's one of the free apps. And you can do it on demo as well, so you can open yourself a demo account and then open the BlackBerry app. And I think RBFX Australia is now doing the same thing. I'm not sure about RBFX USA. So there's certainly more of the brokers are coming doing the same thing. And I think that it's a matter of months before probably all the brokers will have the same thing. It's a full-on BlackBerry app. You can't see charts on it, but you can see plus minus where it's changing. And if you've looked at your screen on the computer and you know what the market, what you've seen and what your technicals are, at least by looking at the BlackBerry app, you can see straight away where you are, what you're trading. You can open and close your trade. You can do absolutely everything on it. It's wonderful.
Cool. Another question coming through from Kevin. Timlani, I'll be with you in a moment. He asks what the two pairs are that you mentioned right up front, the two trading pairs that you typically trade.
Okay. I trade cable, which is UK sterling versus US dollar. Okay, that's called cable. That's the oldest pair that these guys traded literally in the forex market as we know it. And I don't know why they call it cable. Maybe they've traded it via cable in Telex or whatever it is.
Probably did.
Maybe you can answer. I don't know.
I'm not sure, but that's...
I don't know why it's called cable.
Cable sounds about right. So it's cable and the second one, dollar-euro.
It's euro-dollar. Euro-dollar.
So euro-dollar.
Euro versus US dollar.
Okay.
Because of market... of world news and of world events, that's where it all is happening at the moment. I mean, there's so much focus on the whole Eurozone and, you know, the Greek thing and the Italian debt and all those things. So that makes the Euro really, the Eurozone versus the American economy. And that's where a lot of the focus is. So that's where I'm really have been focusing on that for a year. That and then, of course, cable.
Talani, I've activated your mic. You got a question?
Yes. I just want to know about the risk. How much a risk can you take per trade? To what a percentage of the portfolio?
All right. I don't take more than a 2% risk. It doesn't mean that I've never done that, but whenever I've been too sure of myself, and you actually risk a little bit more, it usually comes to bite you with rather big teeth. Okay, as you're trying to run away, it takes a big nip at the buttocks, actually. Takes a large chunk of your count. So the lessons learned, I'd never ever willingly take more than a 2% risk. This current trade is on a very small risk. I'm at something like 0.75% margin. And that's hard to determine this far down the line, because the initial risk was only determined by the size of the stop loss. And I had something like a 15-point stop loss. I picked a very good point of turn in the market, and I had a 15-point stop loss. But the 15-point stop loss was one less than 1% risk.
Yeah, and I mean, typically 2% is considered max. Some folks even won't take more than one. And Tulani, there is, I think you might have attended it, Alwyn's last presentation. Just go to the website, justonelap.com, click on stop losses. You'll see his one, which he bought in the managing risk. Folks, I'm not seeing any more questions come through. So we've got no more questions. I'm going to say my thanks to Alwyn Burger as always. I've got another question. Sutsi, your mic is activated. Activated but not working. Now, ladies and gents, we'll leave it there. Alwyn, as always, thanks for that. I think simple, but I think to your point, perhaps potentially quite powerful and very, very useful, which is really what we are looking for. And simple little tricks like that can make a huge difference. France is a star. He got us the cable quote. Its origins in time, which communications cable under the Atlantic Ocean synchronized the sterling USD quote between London and New York markets. So, Alwyn, you were half right. France, you're an absolute star. So it is that cable. And now we know we can impress our friends. Ladies and gents, we'll leave it there. Alwyn, as always, thanks a lot. Everyone, thanks for attending. Cheers.
Fantastic. Thank you, Simon.